The film opens at Bel Reve Penitentiary, where Savant is in his break room throwing a ball around at targets that he has precisely set up. He even uses his skills to bounce the ball off the walls and kill a canary. He is then pulled away by Amanda as she assigns him to a task. Savant is thrown into the Suicide Squad alongside Blagger, Captain Boomerang, Weasel, Mongal, Javelin, the Detachable Kid, and Harley Quinn. Led by Rick Flagg, then the team travels to the island of Corto Maltese for their mission. Upon arriving, Weasel falls into the water and apparently drowns since nobody knew he couldn't swim. When the squad makes it to land, Blaggard steps out and he said to the mercenaries that his team waiting for them on the beach. For his troubles, he gets his face blown off. Harley goes in blasting while Boomerang throws his signature weapon to slice some heads off. TDK's arms pop off so he can use them as weapons. The mercenaries retaliate and shoot TDK and Javelin dead. Mongal attempts to bring a chopper down but it crashes and she burns to death. Boomerang is impaled with wood and then shredded by the chopper's blades. Harley and Flag go missing while Savant attempts to flee the chaos. Although Amanda warns him, she detonates the explosive in the back of his head, causing it to blow up. Amanda then sends in her second team in the opposite direction to finish the job. 3 days earlier, Amanda goes to recruit Bloodsport, a deadly mercenary who is there for shooting Superman with a kryptonite bullet. Her leverage against him is Bloodsport's teenage daughter Tyla, who is in danger of serving time for stealing. The two argue loudly, as Tyla makes it clear that Bloodsport was a bad father. He goes to threaten Amanda into releasing Tyla, but she knows he is going to comply regardless. After he relents, she introduces him to her other recruits. Peacemaker, a patriotic mercenary. Cleo Kazo, who has the ability to control rats. King Shark, an underwater prince with a taste for human meat. And finally Polka Dot Man, a man with an unusual genetic disorder whose specialty is throwing weaponized polka dots. Amanda informs the team about the situation in Corto Maltese. The nation was overthrown by a dictator named Silvio Luna and his right-hand man General Mateo Suarez after they executed the presidential family. They are operating in a scientific research facility called Jotunheim, where they are conducting dangerous experiments, codenamed Project Starfish. The squad is assigned to find Dr. Gaius Greaves since he can lead them to Jotunheim and they can destroy whatever is going on in there. Presently, while Team 2 is making their way through the jungle, they come across a group that they believe to be mercenaries in league with the military. So the squad kills them before they make it to the camp where Flag is hanging out with his contact Sol Soria. The team found that they killed the freedom fighters who are trying to take Corto Maltese back from Luna and Suarez. The team walks out of the jungle when they notice Polka Dot Man glowing in different colors. He explains that his condition happened because his mother worked at Star Labs and experimented on him and his siblings to give them a superpower. His condition forces him to drain the dots out of him or he will die, and he views all of his enemies as his mother before killing them. Before heading to Jotunheim, Flag insists that they recover Harley. Harley has been taken captive by Luna's men, but he brings her to his room to woo her since she is seen in the country as a symbol of anti-American anarchy. Harley is initially charmed by him, and he even asks her to marry him. However, when he reveals his plan of using whatever is in Jotunheim to eliminate anyone who threatens his regime, even if it means killing children. After that, Harley shoots Luna, leading his men to capture and imprison her. The squad is being taken by Sol's contact, Milton, to go to a bar called La Gatita Amable, where they will find the Thinker. On the road there, Ratcatcher asks Bloodsport why he is afraid of rats, as he is always recoiling around Sebastian, even though, according to Cleo, sees good in Bloodsport. Bloodsport states that his father once punished him with rats, and it leads to his phobia. When he asks her why she is so drawn to rats, she explains that her father taught her how to control them but also treat them as family, but he was a drug addict and ultimately overdosed when she was a child. Bloodsport and Ratcatcher promise to one another that they will get each other out alive. The team makes it to the bar. The squad drinks and dances before they spot Thinker. They apprehend him, but the military comes in to search everyone since they know that there are Americans in there. Bloodsport sends Ratcatcher and Polka Dot Man outside with Thinker, while he, Peacemaker, and Flag are all taken in. On the road, the three subdue the gunman and kill the driver before their van is run off the road. Ratcatcher and King Shark arrive with Thinker in tow. Harley is being tortured by Suarez's men for information, but she never budges. When she is left alone with his guard, she snaps his neck with her legs and sets herself free. Harley proceeds to shoot down Suarez's guards. Outside, Flag tries to lead the squad to rescue Harley until she shows up and joins them. They then get Thinker and order him to get them inside Jotunheim. Thinker leads the squad to the creature that he calls Starro the Conqueror. Peacemaker and Nino set up bombs all over the place. Thinker reveals to the squad that the American government was behind the experiments involving Starro since they have been secretly funding Corto Maltese for decades. Starro also emits smaller starfish that attach themselves to human faces and take over their bodies like zombies, and there are slews of corpses of Starro's other victims all over the facility. Starro breaks free and grabs Thinker, tearing him in two and splattering him across the wall. Flag attempts to secure the hard drive with evidence against the American government to deliver to the press, but Peacemaker turns on him per Waller's orders. The two fight each other, with Flag nearly choking Peacemaker to death, but he stabs Flag through the heart with a piece of a broken sink. Ratcatcher witnesses this and grabs the flash drive while Peacemaker attempts to kill her. Meanwhile, Nino comes across small fish that mimic him until their aquarium is broken and they begin to leech onto him. All while Bloodsport, Harley, and Polka Dot Man try to survive the crumbling facility. Bloodsport manages to survive going through several floors before he lands and witnesses Peacemaker getting ready to execute Ratcatcher. The two mercs draw their guns and fire their bullets at each other, with Bloodsport's bullet breaking through Peacemaker's and striking him in the throat, bringing him down. King Shark falls outside and is shot by Suarez's men, but he rises and bites the head of one gunman before the rest of the squad runs out of the facility as Starro bursts out. It releases more starfish that kill Suarez and his men and then proceeds to make its way into the city. Amanda declares the mission over since the evidence is destroyed, but the squad want to save the city, and she threatens to detonate their devices and kill them on the spot until her subordinate Flo Crawley brains her with a golf club and has the rest of the team guide the squad to save the city. At the same time, Sol and her team execute the remaining members of the regime to stage their coup and take their country back. Bloodsport begins blasting away at Starro while King Shark starts to bite into it. Polka Dot Man envisions Starro as his mother and unleashes his polka dots to burn Starro's leg, but the alien crushes him. Ratcatcher tries to use her beacon to summon the rats, but Bloodsport pushes her out of the way before she is killed. She then uses the beacon and gets practically every rat in the city to take down the infected citizens and start to take Starro down. Harley then charges into Starro's eye with the javelin and breaks through before the rats make their way inside and take Starro down from the inside, finally killing it and saving the city. The squad's heroics are broadcast on the news, and Tyla acknowledges her father as a hero. Bloodsport contacts Amanda, ordering her to let the team and Tyla go free, or they will leak the evidence from the laboratory to the press. She reluctantly agrees and calls for the chopper to bring them home. As the team rests, Rat crawls onto Bloodsport's leg and he begins to pet it. After that, Weasel is shown to still be alive and starts wandering into the jungle of Corto Maltese. John and Amelia are brought to a room where they find that Peacemaker is still alive.